Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what are the types of the voltage cell, in which first was the primary cell and the second was the secondary voltage cell. So now we are going to talk about the primary cell's first example, that is dry cell. So what is dry cell? Let's talk about it. So now let us talk about the dry cell. So this is the schematic diagram that is present on your screen, as you can see that this is a dry cell in which it consists of the main zinc container that you could see. This zinc container is a cylindrical form, and and talking about the next one, that the porous paper spacer is also been kept above it. So it has been covered with a zinc, the zinc container is covered with a porous paper spacer, and the zinc is acting as a anode in this case, as well as the zinc is being acting as an anode in which you could see that there is a presence of paste of NH4Cl plus ZnCl2. So this cylinder is filled with NH4Cl and ZnCl2, which is basically not an aqueous solution but is a paste, as you could see that it is not an aqueous solution but a paste, but it means that it doesn't require any kind of aqueous solution to react or to form electricity, and hence the name is dry cell, because no kind of aqueous material is being used in this process, and hence it is said to be a dry cell. Then talking about the next one, it also consists of an inner graphite rod which is covered with a paste of MnO2 plus carbon. So this graphite rod, which is acting as a cathode while the zinc container, the whole zinc container is acting as a anode, and the overall in this process, the reaction that occurs in this process, the hydrogen are being released, as well as the ammonia that could be released in this process, because the reactant that are being used is NH4Cl and MnO2 that could react with this kind of H4 to form H2O. So this kind of process will have an evolution of hydrogen or ammonia. So as to avoid this thing, the brass cap is being used. So in this case, let me tell you, the brass is not being acting as a positive charge, while the whole cathode is being the graphite rod is being acting like a positive charge, that is cathode, while the zinc is being acting like a negative charge. So the brass cap has a very influential role so as to stop or so as to prevent the release of H2 and ammonia gas from the dry cell. So what are the function of this dry cell and how can it be used? So let us see in the next thing. So when I talk it about the electrode reaction that takes place on the particular electrode like zinc and the other electrode, that is on anode and at cathode, then if I could see that at anode, as we know that oxidation takes place, and in this case the zinc is being acting like a anode. So if zinc is acting like an anode, then obviously it would undergo oxidation process, and in oxidation process the electrons are being lost. So in this process the zinc is being converted into Zn2 plus ions plus 2 electron, which means the solid zinc is being converted into a aqueous solution of Zn2 plus. So this might be an aqueous or this might be liquid state also, because the overall process is in a dry condition, so therefore this would be in a liquid form. So Zn2 plus will also have 2 electrons. So because of this, the Zn2 plus will give 2 electrons. These 2 electrons will be helpful for the other one to get reduced. And what is the other one? Let us see. In this case, the zinc loses the electron and Zn2 plus ion dissolves in the electrolyte. And in which electrolyte? The electrolyte is NH4Cl, and this 2 electrons will act on that NH4Cl, and let us see what happens. So therefore, at cathode, as we know that reduction takes place, and recently we have got to know that the 2 electrons that are being released from the zinc electrode, that is from the anode, So that zinc electrode will act with 2 times of NH4+. And in this case, the NH4+ was the NH4Cl. It was combined with NH4Cl plus MnO2. So these 2 electrons will act on the NH4+ so as to form 2 times of ammonia, that is NH3 plus H2. So this H2, when released, when the electrolyte, that is NH3, when the electrolyte, that is NH4, is being reacted with the 2 times of electron and it forms NH3 and H2. This H2 is being combined with the paste of MnO2 that has been applied on the graphite rod. So that MnO2 will react with this H2 to form Mn2O3 and plus H2O. So this H2, this is the process in which the Mn2O3 is been formed. Again, a solid is been formed in this case, while the H2 which is present, it is in a gaseous form. Even this NH3 is also in a gaseous form. So this is how we get water also. So basically, once the water is being generated, you could know that it was a dry acid, but because of the water, it is being consumed, so therefore we cannot recharge this thing. And the overall process that takes on the cathode can be calculated as 2 times of ammonia, that is 2 moles of ammonia, will react with 2 moles of MnO2. In this case, this H2 and this H2 will get eliminated with each other, and hence we could get 2 times of ammonia plus 2 times of MnO2 that will react with 2 times of electron, so as to get Mn2O3 plus 2 times of ammonia plus H2. So the overall reaction would be what? So I could write the overall reaction as, at anode and at cathode, the overall reaction can be written as we know that at anode, zinc, which was present in a solid form, that has been converted into Zn2+, forming 2 electrons. So this was in a liquid state, or this has been converted into an solution which is mixed in the electrolyte. So now what will happen at cathode that we have recently did? It was 2 moles of NH4+ plus 2 moles of MnO2 plus 2 electron, that will give us Mn2O3 plus 2 moles of ammonia plus H2. So this is the reaction that we have, overall reaction that we have got at cathode. So therefore, I could easily calculate what would be the net cell reaction. In this case, we could eliminate these 2 electrons, and hence we get the final answer as, or the net cell reaction as, in this case, Zn plus 2 times of NH4+ plus 2 moles of MnO2, that will give us Zn2+ plus Mn2O3 plus 2 times of NH3 plus H2. So this is the overall reaction that we get in the dry cell. So now, talking about the next thing, that a few additional point that I am going to talk about is this Zn2+, which is present in an aqueous form, or which is present in an liquid form. I said it act as aqueous form because there is a presence of water which is present in it, in the product. So therefore, this Zn2+ can combine with NH3 so as to form a complex, and that complex forms a precipitate in the cell, and hence, when a dry cell is being completely used and when you break it, so you cannot find any kind of an aqueous material, but all the process would be in a powder form. So that means this is overall said to be a dry cell reaction because an aqueous material is not being used in this process, and as a commonly it is known as a dry cell. So where did we use dry cell, and where do we use dry cell? It is very common. We use in every case. We use in toys, we use in remote control. It is a very, or if A++ batteries that we are using. So these are the normal cells that we are used in torches and all. So a very common method or a very common cell that we are using in our day-to-day life. So this was a representation of a dry cell. I hope you have got understand what is dry cell. So thank you friends for watching this video. Share this video with your friends and yes, please don't forget to subscribe eGeta channel. Thank you so much.